Welcome back, students. We were discussing the topic of human skeleton. So let's continue. Next bone comes the humerus bone. Now this is the bone present in the upper arm, as you can see, and it is a long bone and it goes between the shoulder and the elbow joint. So this bone, which is present in your arm, ranging from here to here, is called as humerus bone, which joins from shoulder to the elbow joints. Next comes the radius and ulna. These are the bones in your lower upper arm. This is the radius. This is ulna. There are two bones joined. And the radius is on the thumb side of your arm. The two bones swivel over each other when you twist your wrist. Next comes the pelvic region. Now your pelvis is like a shape of a bowl. It holds all the organs in the lower part of the body and it's slightly movable joint. Now these joints are present between the center of adjacent vertebrae of the backbone, and the connecting discs are the fibrocartilaginous. These joints help in the, as you can see, this is the mainly joints present here, and these joints help in the shock absorption and protect the spinal cord from the mechanical injury, and these joints make the vertebral column slightly flexible. There are two types of joint present, which is called as the symphysis joint. Now next comes the femur. Femur is the strongest, you can say, bone present inside your body, and it lies at the thigh region. So it is called as thigh bone. It is the longest bone in the body and one of the strongest. It helps to support your weight when you stand. It is the strongest as well as the longest bone found in the human body, as well as it supports the whole body weight. Next comes the tibia and fibula, just below this femur bone. These bones are both in your lower leg. Now the tibia is thicker in size and the fibula is the shimmer in size, that means thinner. This is tibia and this is fibula. Here it's present. Now they both hold the lowering muscles in the place and doesn't give much support strength to legs. Means your main weight is supported by the femur bone. So students, in this session we have seen. Thank you. In next session we will have a more detailed look regarding the human skeleton. Thank you.